Of course, life would be very empty without enjoyable things, without the people that we love, and the deep connections that we can form with them, and without the goals that we have. There's nothing wrong with any of these things. But the problem comes when we see these things as the cause of our happiness. Right? When we depend on these things, then our relationship with another person turns into a kind of business relationship instead of a real giving, a real flow of energy outward through the heart. So it's a matter of finding a healthy relationship with those things so that we can pursue our goals with great passion, but without depending on the outcome. And of course, it's difficult if we have no other idea of how to find contentment, how to find that joy. That's why yoga practice is some form of practice, right? Meditative practice. Any spiritual tradition ultimately has an essential attempt to find that peace or happiness that is inherent, often talked about as the image of God, right? Mm-hmm. That we're all made in the image of God, to attune ourselves to that presence of God or spirit. So that presence, that experience of the internal joy makes it much more possible to be involved in the world without depending, without needing those things to be the source of our happiness. So by saying this, I mean to say that yoga recommends both some kind of practice to help us attune to the self within, the natural joy, the innate sense of love and connection that's already present, and on the other hand, a relationship with the world around us that's a healthy one, that's not dependent